There's many views on the relationship between us and nature and what nature actually is. And I think there's no difference, no border between what we are and what nature is. It's all one big system, and it's not possible to draw a line in between. And everything that we call nature is actually very much influenced by us, either through our industrialization and to our, like, just because we are on the planet, we influence it a lot, but then also we influence it a lot by actually naming it and understanding it. The way we understand it is like very different than an animal understands the ocean. That the fish has a different opinion about the ocean than we. And so it's very humanized, what we call nature. So the whole concept is very artificial. The nature itself used to be a god. And then later, so then we had like separate gods for each part of nature. And then later it became the one god that controls everything. And then now, and then it became science that we would believe in. And science was explaining the ocean or explaining nature. Then when you're like out there on a boat, and the waves are getting a little bit higher than you feel comfortable with, it's not just like the scientific concept of nature. You feel there's someone, there's something that people always refer to as a god or as nature or whatever, depending on the time. And so that's kind of the face of it. Because where do you interact with nature? There are not so many points where you really have the feeling of interaction. And if you get hit by a wave, that's a very strong moment of interaction. You even know it sometimes when you go swimming and the wave is a little bit bigger than you expect, it punches you in the face and you feel like nature hit you in the face. And there are not many moments of that, especially not for people that live in cities. So that's why the ocean is a very like vivid, like a very active part of interaction. And I like it because actually it's a pure movement. Because the water itself, if it wouldn't move, it would just be a completely perfect straight surface. And the movement of it is what it makes kind of a active entity. That's why I'm only showing the movement here, because I think that's exactly the interface that creates a lot of drama between nature and us. And you see, like, it's not just going up and down, it's also shaking back and forth. And for this information, we needed to build our own sensor. So I worked with some friends that made another boy product before, so they were experienced in building electronic sensors on boys. But then we needed someone to help us to actually place it. And we found a SEMREF. It's a research group, like an engineering school in Nantes, and they do similar products than we. So they do research on how to build offshore wind turbines that are swimming, that are not connected to the ground. And for that, they have to do a lot of measurements. So they do very similar things than we do, but for very different purposes. And so we teamed up and they helped us to place our technology on one of their buoys, because they have the ships to do that and they have the experience in how to do it. So right now we have our sensor installed on their buoy, and they can also use our data because it also helps them to understand better the movement of the sea, which is important for their research. I'm putting the viewer into a situation here where I think it's pretty hard for the viewer not to imagine the sea, and you're normally under it, like the sea level is above you, and that's, I think, what most people will imagine, but then they will imagine it in a very different way. And that's what a little bit the work is about the imagination and the creation of nature.